Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today I have another What Sold on Poshmark video. So if you want to check out all the items I sold over this 2-week period, definitely keep on watching. For those of you who might be new here, thanks so much for checking this out. I'm a full-time working mom, but in my spare time I really love making these videos on fashion, beauty, mommy lifestyle, in addition to my reselling experience as well. So if that kind of thing sounds at all interesting to you, definitely keep on watching and definitely consider hitting that subscribe button link down below. I'd really, really appreciate the support. Okay, so for today I want to cover my typical 2-week stretch that I do every time for my Poshmark sales. Typically I do also cover my eBay sales, but again, I made zero eBay sales. That's right, zero eBay sales. So my last What Sold video will see that I had my best eBay sales 2-week period that I have had so far, but this 2-week period, I made zero eBay sales. So that's just how reselling goes, right? You have ups and downs. Sometimes you have really good sales, other times not so much. So I'm in the not so much phase during these 2 weeks. After these 2 weeks, just so you know, things do pick up a little bit during the holiday season, so I wanna share with you that in future videos. But for these 2 weeks, it was not a great 2 weeks. And I even thought about not filming this video because, to be honest, it's quite embarrassing that I had so few sales. I have reasons for having few sales, I would say, but just the fact that I had so few sales, I almost didn't want to shoot this video. But as a reseller, there are ups and downs like I just mentioned. So I think it's important to have full disclosure and to share with you the good and the bad. So this was a bad 2 weeks, to be quite honest, but that's just how it goes. So in case you're interested, I will share with you the few sales I made during this 2-week period. I will share with you all the information on each item, including the sales price minus any Poshmark fees or shipping discounts I may have given. I will not share my cost of goods in this video, but I do share all that information in my haul videos, and I've linked some haul videos down below in case you're curious. In case you're new to Poshmark, definitely consider checking out my closet or anyone else's closet. And if you decide to make your first purchase on Poshmark, if you use my referral code MODMOMMD, that's M-O-D-M-O-M-M-D, you will save $10 on your first purchase. I also get a little bit of a kickback as well, which is really cool too. So definitely consider using my referral code if you're new to Poshmark. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jump into my 2 weeks of sales. And again, sales were definitely down. And the reason largely is because I just didn't put much effort into Poshmark during these 2 weeks and the weeks prior. The main reason is my day job was picking up, I was taking more hospital shifts, and things were just really busy. So I did not list any item over these 2-week period. I also didn't really share that much. So at most I'd be able to share once a day, if that. So you can really see how your Poshmark productivity falls down when you do that. But that's just how life is. This is a part-time job for me, I would say, or part-time hobby even, I should say. So, you know, I don't have such great expectations, especially if my full-time job is picking up, I have to focus on that. So that's kind of what happened during these 2 weeks, but I'm still thankful for every sale that I always make. So I'm excited to share with you these particular items. I think I have some good ones in here. Okay, so the first item that sold was this Miss Me jeans. It's a black distressed embellished skinny jean in size 28. So I love this jean, as you can see here. It's the typical black colorway, but as you can see, there are angel wings with bling on them on the back pockets. So just really gorgeous, unique style from Miss Me. And Miss Me is known for this bling on their back pockets, I would say, in general. So Miss Me is a line of jeans that I think sells okay. So if you can find a unique item like this, I think it's worthwhile considering picking up. Just standard Miss Me jeans, especially if not in good condition, you definitely don't want to pick up, I would say. But if it's good condition and a really unique style, I think it can do well. The problem is this particular jean I sat on for well over 9 months. I'm not sure exactly why, but I did sell it for a decent price point. So I believe I sold this for full asking price of $45. Poshmark fees were $9, and my net earnings were $36 on these pair of jeans. So it's definitely a worthwhile pickup for me, and I will definitely consider Miss Me going forward as well. The next item that sold was an item from my personal closet, and it's this pair of CL, and that's Chinese Laundry by Laundry, peep toe flats in a size 7. So as you can see, here's a basic pair of peep toe flats. They're in great condition. I wore them probably a couple of times, like most of my shoes, unfortunately, these days, but I had this for many years. I just never wore them, so it was time to kind of move them along for my closet. It had this snake print design, just a very basic kind of flat, but with some unique features and some gold foiling as well. So I thought they're really cute. I just don't use them anymore, so I decided to move them along, and they did sell for an offers to likers of $19. Poshmark fees were $3.80, and my shipping discount was $2.12. So my net earnings were $13.08. So not a huge profit margin, but you know, it was an item that I had purchased for myself, so really happy to move these items along always. The next item was another item, go figure, from my personal closet that I just hadn't used. It's this Max New York tote in black. and I actually sold it for my full asking price of $16. Poshmark fees are $3.20 and my net earnings are $12.80. So this particular item I also had for years, I just really hadn't used. I think I probably didn't use it at all, to be honest. The tags were not on it anymore, but I don't remember ever having used this bag. So I was really happy to move this along just because I don't use it at all. And the buyer actually left me a really cool note. It sounds like she already has this bag and was looking for a placement, she said, and this is perfect. So I was really happy about that. It's a very basic large tote that you can use, especially for traveling. I think it would be amazing. Even as a work tote, I think it would work as well. So this was an amazing find that I had years ago that I never used. I'm happy that somebody else could enjoy it. The next item that sold was a pair of booties. It's from Adrienne Vittadini, and it's a topaz suede heeled ankle boot, as you can see here in a size 10. So this is just a very basic, cute ankle bootie. It has some really nice scalloping details, as you can see at the top there. And the front was really nice too. It kind of cut down on the vamp a little bit with some elasticized details. So I thought it's just a very basic, perfect bootie for this time of year. I think it would be amazing for the workplace as well. And it was in suede, so really nice boot. It had some wear on it, but it wasn't really significant at all, I would say. So ultimately, I did sell this for a best offer of $20. Poshmark fees were $4, and my net earnings were $16 on these booties. And I also got a really amazing love note from the buyer that was very, very happy with these shoes. So I'm really appreciative of that as well. So I don't typically pick up this brand of shoes when I'm outsourcing, but if you find a really cute style like this, I think it's worthwhile to consider. But as you can see, the resale value isn't all that great for this particular line, so I definitely would be wary of the style. The next item was a pretty unique item that I hauled from one of my Southern California thrift hauls that is linked down below if you want to check out. And this is just a unique hand-carved leather belt. There was no brand attached, but it was hand-carved. It said that on the belt. It was just a very unique style, kind of a one-of-a-kind type of a belt, I would say. And it had a really nice carving of a floral type of palm print, as you can see here. And these belts, it's really hard to give sizing, but I measured everything. I measured the width, I measured the full length from the buckle to the end, the largest waistband circumference, and the smallest based on where the holes were. I gave all those measurements, and hopefully somebody would find that helpful, I thought. And sure enough, this particular buyer was happy with this purchase. And I ultimately sold it, I believe, for full asking price of $15. Poshmark fees are $3, so my net earnings are $12. So again, not a huge profit margin, but as I've said before on this channel, I'm really trying to expand my Poshmark closet to include a lot more accessories. So namely belts so far, I've been trying to get into more. So I wanted to give this one a try, and I think belts are worthwhile considering picking up. I'm not sure if I would pick this one up in particular in the future just because the resale point was not so great. But other belts, there are certain lines that I will talk about going forward on this channel that I think do pretty well. And belts are super easy to store and to ship, obviously. So that's a huge bonus. So definitely something to consider in terms of trying to expand your closet and getting into more accessories, especially belts. The next item was a Boden item. It's a Boden cotton blend skirt with pockets in a size 2. So as you can see here, it was this really dark eggplant color and in pockets. It's kind of a mini length skirt, I would say. And I love Boden, as I've talked about every single time I do these videos. And these items sell, even skirts. And in general, skirts for me just do not sell very well. I'm not sure exactly why, but for all the categories of bottoms, skirts probably do the least well. So I'm very cautious about picking up skirts, but I always consider Boden, as I've said before. So this one also worked out pretty well for me. I did accept a best offer of $25. Poshmark fees are $5, so my net earnings are $20 on this skirt. So I did make some profit. I mean, it wasn't spectacular or anything, but it moved along relatively quickly. So I would definitely consider picking up these skirts again in the future. The next item was a fun pair of Stella McCartney for Adidas. It was called the Krigia Flat in a size 7.5. So the Stella McCartney line for Adidas, I think, does extra well. People are kind of searching for it and collect it, I would say. And this is a basic pair of flats. It had a blush elasticized ankle strap, as you can see here, but just a very nice athleisure flat, I would say. I did haul this in one of my ThredUp shoe rescue box hauls, which is linked down below if you want to check it out. But I really love those hauls because I find a lot of really cool items that I wouldn't normally find out thrifting. So this is one of those examples. So this particular shoe, I did ultimately sell for full asking price of $30. Poshmark fees were $6, and my net earnings were $24 on these pair of shoes. So I always consider picking up Adidas, especially if they're a trendy style, and the Stella McCartney line from Adidas, I think, kind of fits that category. So if I did see this out thrifting, I definitely would consider picking it up too. And believe it or not, I just have one final sale for this 2 week period, and it's ironically another Bowdoin skirt. So two Bowdoin skirts this week sold, which is pretty interesting. So this particular skirt was a little different than the last one I just mentioned. This was 100% wool, it was fully lined, it was in black, and it was in a size UK 8. So a size UK 8 translates to a US size of 4. So with Bowdoin, that's one thing to be wary of, and that is that if you have just one size on the Bowdoin tag, it's typically the UK sizing. Some Bowdoin tags have both the UK and the US, so that makes it easy for you. But if it just has one size, like this one said 8R on the tag, that you can assume is the UK sizing. And you can tell just by looking at the item, it's obvious usually what size it is, but 8R UK is 4 in US. So just be wary of that so you list it correctly in your closet. But this is a size 4 US, 100% wool black skirt, which was just amazing condition, really no significant flaws at all. So this particular skirt did sell for a best offer of $38. Poshmark fees are $7.60. So my net earnings were $30.40. And the buyer just loved this skirt as well. I thought it was an amazing skirt too. Just really perfect for this time of year. You just can't go wrong with Bowdoin. Alright, so that video was short and sweet. Those were all the sales that I made during this 2 week period. Again, not a whole lot, but I have reasons for it. Nonetheless, I'm so thankful for every sale that I make, and every one is really special, and I think you can learn something from every single sale you make. So I hope this video was helpful. If you have any amazing sales you've been making recently, definitely leave them in the comments down below. I'm always curious to hear about new brands and things I need to be checking out as well. Otherwise, I hope you're staying safe and healthy with your family, and I will plan to see you again in my next video. Take care. Bye.